Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Just wanted to share the news that I now have a Patreon page to help support this channel so that I can hopefully keep doing this for a while. So head on over to patreon.com/vitalvinyl, and vital vinyl is spelled the same dumb way that this show is spelled. And check out the stuff, see if any of that interests you. I've got some pretty cheap little sketches and even the opportunity to suggest an album for me to review, either digitally or physical vinyl-y. Maybe I should include a tier to add awesome effects, or just keep it the way it is. I don't even know what that effect would be. So maybe I should add a tier where I would learn what the hell it is that I'm talking about sometimes. But then that would erase some of the charm of this show. All right, so yeah, check it out. I'll put a link below. Toodles. Hey gang, welcome to another episode. Today we are going to be looking at the Audio-Technica LP60X turntable. This is not the USB one or the Bluetooth or anything like that. And I know there's LP60X BT, which is the Bluetooth, but then there's also the ATLP60 Go. Get it? Because Go looked like 60. But that one's also Bluetooth, but I think that one might be exclusively at Walmart. I don't know what the difference between those two is, but it doesn't matter because that's not what we're looking at today. All right, this is a turntable that I got for my daughter last year for her birthday. She's been rocking it for about 6-7 months now and seems to be going pretty good so far. So let's get into it and see what we got. It does have a dust cover to keep dust from being covered from your record player covered dust thing. Love whenever I can't talk. The dust cover is removable either at the hinges, or you can slide the hinges out completely if you like a cleaner, more, I don't know, undust covered look. Like some of the way expensive high-end turntables for some reason don't have dust covers, which I never really understood, because wouldn't you want to keep your shit clean, especially if you're paying hundreds, if not thousands of dollars? Yeah, me too. So I recommend keeping it on, but that's just me. It comes with a little 45 adapter. If you're playing the little 7-inch 45 RPM singles, you know, the little records with the big hole in the middle, kind of like your mom. Oh. Which goes on the spindle. Whoops, calm down, boy. All right, let's wait for that to stop, and then I'll pick it up, because I accidentally hit it, and I'm not going to edit that out. It also has speed selector for 33 and 45 RPM, 45 if you push it in, 33 if it's out. Most 12-inch records are 33 RPMs, and most 45 Most 7-inch singles are 45 RPMs, but sometimes the record companies will throw you for a loop and make a 12-inch record that's 45 RPM. Isn't that amazing? All right, you've got your record size selector, 12-inch or 7-inch, again, for those records that I was talking about before. This is a fully automatic turntable, so you can just start it up and it will automatically go raise up and lower onto the record and play, and then it'll stop whenever you hit the stop button and go back to where it was. And it also retracts at the end of the record if you're playing it. You can do it manually as well. Raise it up, move it over to where you want, but whenever it gets to the end, it'll automatically lift up and go back to where it was. So if you fall asleep or pass out or leave the house or get murdered, you don't have to worry about the record continually playing and wearing out your stylus. That's a fancy word for needle. Yeah, so personally, I prefer to raise and lower the tone arm manually on a record. So you just hit this little button and it raises it up. Now this, it does drop kind of fast if you do it, if you just let it go like that. So personally, I prefer to lower it down, like myself kind of letting it out. So it lowers a little bit slower, just so it doesn't really slam the needle onto your record, which can damage the tip of the stylus. But one cool thing about these is that the stylus is replaceable. It's an Audio-Technica, makes their own stylus, the 3600L, I believe. But there's also an upgrade. You can, because this is a conical stylus, and you can upgrade it to an elliptical stylus sold by LP Gear. I'll put a link to that in the description below. Maybe. And it's a blue stylus instead of the white. So it gives you a splash of color on your turntable, which this is available in a variety of colors. I went for the gunmetal. Pew, pew, pew. You can get it in black. You can get it in brown. You can get it in red. You can get it in green, except no, you can't. Let's see, go through some more features. Oh, and there's actually another secret feature at the end of this that most of you probably don't even know about, and it's gonna blow your mind, so stick around. Okay, getting to the tone arm itself. There is not an anti-skate controller. There is not an adjustable counterweight, but everything that I've looked up about this turntable kind of suggests that you don't really need that. The tracking force is pretty awesome. The weight of this is, I don't know, I think like around 2-3 grams, something like that. So it's not bearing down on your record, either messing up your stylus or messing up your albums, more importantly, which a lot of more lower end, low cost turntables, they definitely suffer from that. And this is a low-cost turntable, but it's really pretty cool. This one, this basic one right here, costs like around $130, and I think the Bluetooth version is like around, I don't know, between $150 and $200, something like that. And let's see. Oh, so for connecting it into the back, let's pause and flip this thing around, shall we? We shall. Here we are at the exciting rear end of this turntable. Noise ears. You've got your power supply, which plugs in to a power supply. So the thing gets energy and electricity to power it. This is your cable to produce sound. So my daughter has this hooked up to a pair of powered speakers, you know, speakers that you plug in. So when you have that, it comes with this cable, not this cable, this is my cable, but it comes with this cable that is your standard 3.5 millimeter aux plug on one side into a single cable, but then at the other end, it splits into two RCA jacks. So this is if you're hooking it up to a receiver. But if you're not, you can just plug in, because regular powered speakers have a little aux cable
like this, and it just plugs right into there. Now, if you're doing that, you want to make sure this switch is set to line over here. But don't do it if it's plugged into a receiver, because then you'll get some background hum like you can hear right now. Switch back to phono, because it is plugged into the phono jacks in the back of this receiver. Now you can, if you have a receiver that does not have a phono jack, or for whatever other reason you might want to, you can plug these two cables into the aux jacks of the back of a receiver, which can be used for CD player, tape deck, laser disc, I don't know, whatever you want. Maybe you have two turntables and you want to switch back and forth. Then you can plug one end into here and then the other end into the aux jack. Make sure the red is in the right one and the white is in the left one. Or usually it's just top and bottom. If it's an older one, it's usually top and bottom. So red goes on the bottom, white goes on the top. And if it's a side-by-side, red goes in the right, white goes in the left. And then if you have it like that plugged into the aux jack, then when you're on your receiver, make sure that it's set to aux, not to phono. All right, wasn't that exciting? I thought so too. All right, you've seen what she can do, but now the real test. Let's see how she sounds. I've got this hooked up, like I said, to my receiver and my speakers, and I'm about to play one of my records. Sounds pretty awesome to me. Yeah, and despite the things that I said about no counterweight, no anti-skate, and all that, I trust this to play my albums, you know? This is my personal copy of Nirvana's Nevermind. A palace pressing at that. Ooh. Whatever. Yeah, this is a really, 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 really awesome turntable, especially for the price. I know it's a low cost compared to some whatever high-end turntables out there, but it sounds good. It performs amazingly. It's got fully automatic features. So if you're just looking for a regular turntable that plays good, sounds good, works good, does what it should do, then I highly recommend the Audio-Technica LP60X. Thanks so much for joining me, and I'll see you in a minute to show you that special secret feature. So when I was looking up information about the LP60, I made an amazing discovery. It's got this feature. That's so cool, they had to keep it a secret. And the crazy thing is, once I tell you, it's going to blow your mind, but within a few seconds, you're going to forget all about it. Like, they've somehow built it in that way to where, it amazes you, and you're like, oh my God, that's so cool. And then within a few seconds, you forget, no matter how hard you try. So try and stick with me. So here goes. The LP60 can wing, going, gone. Forgotten about, right? Isn't that crazy? I don't know how they did that, but yeah. Sorry, couldn't be more helpful. But trust me, for a second,
you just couldn't believe, like, your whole world was about to shatter around you. But yeah, so I'd highly recommend I'd highly recommend learning how to talk. Okay. I highly recommend getting one of these turntables, the Audio-Technica LP60X. There's also a Bluetooth version. There might be a USB version too. I don't know. But just the regular one, it's pretty cool. All right. Till next time, have a blessed day.